Alright, hey guys, with Abomination9 here, and we're back playing some more Pokemon Trading Card Game Online. We left off, we had opened the packs I got from four-starring the first half of the Platinum League, and I've beaten the rest of the Platinum League now. As you can see, they're all four-starred, so I got six more packs, though beating the last guy did give me, or four-starring the last guy gave me like three or four packs, I think. So we're at 12 packs now. I also bought three with the money I'd collected from beating all of them, as it stacked up, obviously. Now, the code redemption is back, so in the next video, I'm probably going to be reopening a bunch of packs since all the cards I got from the 27 openings are gone. I would assume, or at least some of them, or most of them are gone. So I have to assume that the codes are working again. So the video after this might be like 50 million openings. Okay, nothing too crazy here. We literally only got one new Pokemon, which I didn't have a Duskull, so I finally have one, thank God. So yeah, just Duskull, Scraggy, Seedot, Stunky, Pidgey, Nuzleaf. Roserade, Sentret, and Mega Charizard EX evolves from Charizard EX. Oh my god. We literally got Charizard EX the other video. I don't think it was the last video. I think it was the video before that, right? Yeah, two videos ago. So number four, because I think the last one was five. So number four, I got regular Charizard EX. And now I got the Mega, so now I have a package, though. I don't know if I have a. What the? Okay, so this does say Chrism Dive or whatever. Kuren. What? Let me actually. Gren Dive. Actually, it doesn't. It says Gren Dive. Yeah. This doesn't say Chrism Dive for some reason. It says Gu. Re n dai bu. So Gren Dive. So is that like Grim Dive? Is that what it's trying to say? Grim Dive? And we chose to say Crimson? Crimson Dive? I'm pretty sure Crimson in Japanese is I know the word. Is it Kurenai? I think Crimson is Kurenai in Japanese, so they could have just put Kurenai dive right there, but they chose Gren, whatever that is. But yeah, Crimson Dive, 300 damage. I mean, 220 health, and he hurts himself for 50, so which isn't too much when you're hitting for 300. This kills another Mega Charizard. This kills any other EX. This is like a super EX killer. 300 damage. Like, what the heck? Jesus Christ. Jigglypuff, cool. Jigglypuff, Slugma, Zoruna, Ponard, Sandile, Inkay, a special version of Inkay, which might go in my Dark Fairy deck, Electrode, and a Cloyster. I didn't have a Cloyster. I've been waiting to get one. Finally, I have one. Cloyster. Clamp Crush, 30 damage. Also, he only has 100 HP, which is eh. Flip a coin. If heads, your opponent's active Pokemon is now paralyzed and discard an energy attached to that Pokemon. That's pretty good. So, 30 damage isn't too hot, but to paralyze them and get rid of their energy, that's decent. A Spike Cannon, 30 times. Flip 5 coins. His attack does 30 damage times the number of heads. Wow. They're like, what, 150? My god. Now, I guess 150 isn't too much, but that's if you're lucky. You could, like, throw all tails, I don't know. But yeah, that's a decent card. But I mean, we just got Mega Charizard, so what can top that? Every time I come into this not expecting too much, and then first Pokemon to get it's a freaking Mega Charizard. So clearly I don't know what I'm talking about. Another unknown, Combee, a Malamar, Spinarak, Oddish, Forest of Giant Plants. I haven't seen that before. Is that a stadium? Each player's plant Pokemon can evolve during his or her first turn or the turn he or she has played. Okay. Belsum, Sableye, Lucky Helmet, and a Gyarados. Cool. Already have one of these in the theme deck, so I'm pretty sure that means I own a Gyarados. But this Gyarados is really strong. It's 130 health. Berserk Splash, which does 80 damage to your opponent and 10 to everyone. Everyone's bench Pokemon, yours and theirs. But if you have that combined with a stadium, not the stadium, but a stadium that heals all your Pokemon, your water Pokemon and electric, but in this case you care about your water ones, for 30 every turn, it pretty much negates him. And as long as you're not fighting against another water electric deck, you can pretty much just keep dumping damage onto their bench. And then Aqua Tail, which is 90 damage, which is pretty decent, but for every energy attached to him, so you would keep just throwing energy on Gyarados, even past his 4 limit, you flip a coin for each energy, and for every hedge, you do 30 more damage, so it pretty much has unlimited damage if you're lucky and just keep dumping energy onto the Gyarados. Okay, another Eevee. I needed another one. Did I get another Vaporeon recently? I think I did. So Eevee, Wooper, Larvesta, Golett, Rots, Porygon 2. Again, still don't have a normal Porygon. I'm at a Tang, Sligoo, and Entei. Which, if Entei isn't that amazing, I have one of these already. From the Fire theme deck. But Burning Roar, discard the top 4 cards of your deck. If any of those are energy cards, attach them as you like to your Pokemon. And Combat Blaze is decent if you're running against a electric deck that is trying to use, like, Circle Circuit, where they'll put down a stadium that ups your bench Pokemon to 8, and then they use a Raichu that does 20 damage times the number of Pokemon on their bench. So this can counteract that by this attack does 20 more damage for each of your opponent's bench Pokemon. So essentially, a reverse Circle Circuit is how he works. But if your opponent has no bench Pokemons, this thing literally only does 20 damage. The Entei only has a natural base damage of 20, which is eh. But, I mean, Entei, man. It's Entei. Okay, we got a Relicanth, a Golett Relicanth, Larvesta, Combi, Baltoy Rotom. That's like our third Rotom. The goth chick that I talked about really liking. Whimsicott, a Lucky Helmet, and a Regice. Oh snap, another legendary right after Entei. 120 HP, Ice Beam, flip a coin of hedge, your opponent's active Pokemon is now paralyzed, so 30 and a chance to paralyze, and 70, Resistance Blizzard. During your opponent's next turn, prevent all effects of attacks, including damage done to this Pokemon by EX. So this is, you would put this in your EX killer deck, essentially, because as long as you can get Regice onto the field and have him go first before the EX is now, null and void. If Regice has 3 energy, of course, all EXs are null and void. Unless you kill that EX and they have a backup EX, then you might be screwed. Which they probably will, because now I haven't played standard in like a few days simply because of all the EXs, but like when I was playing standard, you pretty much was just running into people with like 20,000 EX cards or running decks like that they've copied from other people. Like, can't you be original for once? Like, make your own deck. Don't be copying other people on the internet. Like, is it that serious? Like, so I don't have any of these cards because I guess I haven't opened that many breakpoints, so I'll remember to buy more breakpoints or breakthroughs. Slowpoke, Esper, Electabuzz. So Electabuzz only has Knuckle Punch. Shinx, Numel. Misty's Determination, though this is the new Misty, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the new Misty. I'm all about that old school Misty, the original waifu. I mean, that's probably the first time I've ever said the word waifu on my channel. But she's the OG waifu. Let's read this anyways, even though this is the new school Misty, and I don't really know if I like the way she looks. Discard a card from your hand. If you do, look at the top 8 cards of your deck and put one of them into your hand. Shuffle the other cards back into your deck. It's okay. Krikatoon. Is that an item or an actual supporter? That's a supporter. Krikatoon. Bursting Balloon, which I think this does damage if your Pokemon dies. This card is attached to one of your Pokemon. Discard it at the end of your opponent's turn. Oh, okay. If this Pokemon this card is attached to is your active Pokemon is damaged by an opponent's attack, put 6 damage counters on the attacking Pokemon. Okay, so it's not after, like, after it dies. It's like, if they hit you with this on, they're taking 60 damage. Growlithe and... what is this? Of the evolution of the Scrub. A Dragalge? I don't know how to pronounce that. These weird names they keep adding. Severe Poison. Your opponent's active Pokemon is now poisoned. Put 4 damage counters instead of 1 on that Pokemon between turns, which that's really bad. Like 40 damage that you can't really do anything about? Man. This, though, is not okay. I guess you would put this in a deck that wants to discard. Like the stupid B deck or the March deck that everyone's using. Like, again, be original, please. 60 damage, discard a card. Okay, looks like we have opened a lot of breakthroughs, so we need the break points. So I need break points, I think I need primal something, the one with the Groudon on it. And maybe the Gengar. I bought 2 Mega Gengars because I thought I haven't opened too many of those. Swablu, plus I want Mega Gengar, or just a Gengar in general. Rufflet, Ralts, Chespin, Dudo, Quilava. This is a Mewtwo Spirit Link, which I have a Mewtwo EX, so I guess that works. Pull it in. A Judge and a Marowak, sharpshooting with 100 health. This attack does 30 damage to one of your opponent's Pokemon. That's okay. Bone Windmill, 60. If your opponent's active Pokemon is Pokemon EX, switch this Pokemon with one of your benched Pokemon. Okay, so that's weird. So you do 60 damage and then you get Marowak out of there. If you're fighting an EX. That's okay if you want to get your own EX out there and you have it fully loaded with energy. Or something that can resist an EX's massive damage. Okay, so Nobat, Pansage, Ralts, Cubone to go with that Marowak, Skiddo, Frogadier, Glalie, Spirit Link, which I already have one of those, another Snorlax, that's pretty cool, Professor's Letter, and another Ice Cream Cone, which we have probably a couple of these already. 130, Frigid Breath, 30 until the end of the next turn. Each player can't play any supporters or stadium cards from his or her hand. And Deep Freeze, flip a coin. If Heads, your opponent's active Pokemon is now paralyzed. If Tails, your opponent's active Pokemon is now confused. So it's pretty good attack. Like, this Pokemon's pretty good. Because 70 damage and a guaranteed paralyze or confusion is nice. Only a couple new ones there. Swablu, Cyndaquil, Woobat, Pansage, Scatterbug, Assault Vest, Froxer. We have Bridget. Search your deck for 1 basic Pokemon EX or 3 basic Pokemon, except for Pokemon EX, and put them onto your bench. Shuffle your deck afterwards. This card is broken. Grab an EX or grab 3 Pokemon. Well, I guess it's not broken, but it's like, whew, Jesus. It is new too, so I've never gotten a Bridget before. Hoot Hoot. Add another Xerneas. Cool, now I have like 80. I have 2 Xerneases, so now I can put this in that fairy deck to have 3 of them. So, 120 health. Rainbow Force. This attack does 30 more damage for each different type of Pokemon on your bench. It only has 10 base. If this Pokemon was healed during this turn, this attack does 80 more damage. Power creation. So, 80 base up to 160 if you heal it. Okay, now for our Mega Gengar, Phantom Forces. Alright, so Wismer, Wismer, Muna, Yanma, Litwick, Carblast, Louder, to go with our Wismer, Fletchinder, Pharaoh, Seawaddle. Oh, cool, Chandler. Yeah, we can go all the way to the top, can't we? Who does Litwick involve into? Does Litwick involve into Lampent? Because I have a Lampent. I'm pretty sure. Is this Chandler? Chandler's new. It's also holographic as well. So yeah, I'm pretty sure Litwick turns into Lampent, and then we can get our Chandler going as well. So that's finally, because I really like Chandler after seeing him in Pokken. So yeah, Fainting Spell. He has 130 HP, by the way. Fainting Spell. If this Pokemon is knocked out by damage from an opponent's attack, flip a coin to the attacking Pokemon is knocked out. Whoa. So you have a 50-50 chance of killing the enemy if they kill him. Cursed Drop. Put 6 damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon in any way you like. That attack is really good. So this negates all resistances, armor, knockback, etc. That's really good. That's a good attack. And you can probably just kill... Most basic Pokemon are about 60 to 70. So like this Moon is 70, but like this Litwick's only 50. This Wismer's only 60. This Seawaddle's only 50. This is only 50. So you can kill most basic Pokemon if your opponent just has basic Pokemon on the bench. And even so, like some of these are 50. I know Magikarp is only 30. So you can like kill one and put an extra 10 maybe on the active Pokemon. You might not even want to attack the active Pokemon. You might just want to kill their bench and have them do damage to Chandler and hope that his passive pops. Also, we got a Lampent there. And he does evolve from Litwick. So we do have the full evolution. Finian, Bronzer, Totodile, Venonat, Joltik, Lampent, Pharaoh, Target Whistle. Haven't seen this before. Put a basic Pokemon from your opponent's discard pile onto his or her bench. Okay, maybe if they have like a Magikarp and you just want to have an easy kill or something. Battle Compressor and a Diancie? I don't know if I've seen this Pokemon before, but it's a fairy with 90 health, Sparkle. The defending Pokemon tries to attack during your opponent's next turn. Your opponent flips a coin. If Tails, that attack does nothing, which is Diamond Storm for 3 energy. 60 damage. Heal 30 damage from each of your fairy Pokemon. So his second attack's pretty good. 60 damage isn't too much, but healing everything you got is nice. We didn't get our Gengars, though. Now, finally, for our Primal Clash, which I only think I've opened, like, one or two of these. I think this is where I got the Groudon from, or the Mega Groudon. Whatever version, I don't remember. Oh, we got Mr. Mime! Oh, it's not the one I want, though. I want the Mr. Mime that blocks all damage to your bench. Trampinch, Torchic, Mudkit, Chinchou, Bitoff, Lantern, to go with our Chinchou. Mr. Mime, which I want to read this one. Trick. Move a Pokemon tool card attached to one of either player's Pokemon to another of that player's Pokemon that doesn't already have a Pokemon tool attached to it. If there is no Pokemon to move the Pokemon tool card to, this attack does nothing. And 2. Lock up. For 30 damage, the defending Pokemon can't retreat. So, He's not the greatest, Mr. Mime. The one I'm talking about probably way better was negate damage to your bench. And you'd put this in like a Zapdos deck. Because Zapdos does, I think, like 120 damage or something to the defending Pokemon, but does like X amount of damage to your bench, but not theirs. But if you have that Mr. Mime that I'm talking about that negates all damage to your bench, that's really good. Or even better, a Mr. Mime and a Gyarados deck where you have Gyarados hit the opponent for 80 and do 10 to all of his bench and none to yours. Groudon Spirit Link, cool, because we have a Mega Groudon, I think, at least. Do we have a Mega Groudon or a regular Groudon? I don't know which one. I need Arena. Maybe we can get a Groudon here. No, just a full card art Electric. So we didn't get really... We only got like one EX, right? Which was Mega Charizard. Thrash, flip a coin. If Hedge, this attack does 20 more damage. If Tails, this Pokemon does 20 damage to itself. So if heads, he does 70. If tails, he hurts himself. Eh. So that's it. Hopefully, I can get some redeems after this video, because it is here, though the trading is not here, which is I'm perfectly fine with, because as you can see here, I don't care. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Tune into the next episode. Like, subscribe, comment. You know what to do. See ya.